Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Here we are again with another Marvel Future Fight video. Today it is the day to announce the winners of the latest giveaway. I'm a little bit disappointed because the giveaway and watching the video is two different things. As you know, I am Star Agent and they give me 20 codes, so I'm trying to give as many codes as I can from inside my video, so a little bit to boost my channel and a little bit to help you also. So every single month, from the first of the month and until the 15th of the month, I'm running a giveaway that all you have to do, it is this specific thing that I will do right now. So before I show you how exactly you are able to participate in my giveaways from now on, I will show you, because we didn't have enough competitors and I still have enough codes, I will start another giveaway from today until the end of the month. So there is still a competition will run after this specific one finished. So I will make my own entry just for you to see how this works. So you are going here. So those were the competitors from the latest giveaway. From 15s I had only 4. Those guys are supporting the channel since the beginning and they're winning since the beginning 300 diamonds each giveaway. So yeah, if you really want to win one code like those guys, all you have to do is go here on this link that I will have down below in the description. Okay, this will appear to you. What you have to do is choose wherever you like from those over here. You have Twitter, login with Twitter. You have Google, Facebook or email. Okay, I will join with email. My email is this one and my name is Angel Wing Gaming. Okay, notify me for of other Angel Wing Gaming combat content optional. Yeah, oh sorry, it is I did it. Yeah, here the name and here the email and you press save. Okay, I am already in. This is what I have to do. Okay, when I am logging, first I have to visit my Angel Wing Gaming channel on Facebook, then go to Instagram, you open in a new page and yeah, you did it. Then follow Angel Wing on Twitch, you open it, you follow it. It is free. All you have to do is just do it once, just make one profile on Twitch, follow me, and after that you don't have to do anything else yet. You just press like I did on Instagram, because I already follow my page, and yeah, you just press it and this is auto clicked. Then visit Angel Wing Facebook, yep, the same. Visit Angel Wing gaming channel on YouTube, here we are. Visit what kind of videos do you like to watch, just choose whatever the question will be. I like ABX, Alliance Battle Extreme, and you're done. Whenever you click on all of them, you just get your entries. Okay, here you are, you got your entries, that's it. So guys, you really it is really easy. I really cannot understand, you don't really want diamonds. Anyway, today's video will be about Iron Man. So Iron Man, before it was a character of Blast superhero, okay? That was the latest uniform we had from Avengers Endgame with his team suit, that is a synergy uniform. They were quite good uniforms. You could easily, not easily, but you could kill Null, but this specific uniform, guys, it is really another thing. I know the Iron Man became villain with this one, If you're about to search about his uniform options, here you are. The first one it is, Star-Lord. The second one it is Doctor Strange. The third one is War Machine, the team suit. The other one is Killmonger, and the last one it is Black Widow, the black uniform, not the white. So, I a little bit add some work on him, such as the ISO set. I just put a rage on him, a pure rage. I finish a little bit with skills, and this is the outcome of him. So with pure, I just gave a little bit of attention to him, and this is the actual stats he is able to get. So you will tell me that basically I had the same Iron Man before with this uniform, and he was clearing null so difficult. He couldn't do it easily. So I'm going to show you, because many of you ask me and tell me that I'm using the rotation. It is 3, 5, and 4. There is not a wrong rotation when you have a rage. The rage opens for 5 seconds, and you are able in those 5 seconds to do whatever you like. Okay, whatever the rotation will be. But the thing is, whenever the rotation, the rage open, it starts counting. So when this counts, you really have to use the longest animation skill first. This is why we are trying to use the skills that can be cancelled, like 5 and 3 first. So the longest animation, it is the fourth one. Look at how much time it really needs to finish. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It really needs 6 seconds. So if you really need to finish with this specific skill, you need to start with 3-5 or 5-3. I suggest you to start with 5, because not only you are acquiring the beam, but you are also not opening fast the proc, because you are able to cancel it as fast as you can. 5, 3, and 4. This is the actual rotation that I suggest you. So if you cancel the third skill, as I'm telling you, press 5, 3, and 6, you still have the unibeam effect here. So you still will do the increased damage. Some of you think that starting with this one is a good opportunity, but if you start with this one, sometimes the proc from the rage opens fast, and this makes the character being unable to finish the last 2 seconds of the fourth skill. So this is what I suggest you to do. It is 5, 3, and 4. Whenever you have the tier 3 skill, 5, 3, and 6. Okay? So we are going to try this on null. So the team that I was using, because I really like to separate the supports and make the my teams work a little bit better, because I'm using one support in each team, or two supports whenever a character needs it. So I was using this team over here, but the best one, it is this specific team over here. I'm using Medusa, because if you go over here on the activated bonus, he's getting a 5% energy attack increasement. So as I told you in my previous videos, all you have to do is choose wisely your leadership skill, choose wisely your team bonus heroes, and try to get as much stats you can. So with this specific team, let me So those are the stats of Iron Man right now. So he's with 43k thousand energy attack. and those are the stats we are going to test Null. I know you're waiting for Null for stage 5, but for you to make stage 5 it is a little bit difficult. That's why I'm trying the stage 4. The stage 2. Because my Ironman isn't well built to progress a little bit further, and it will take us so much time. I don't want to, you know, take this time from you. Okay, so let's go test the Nulls. So as for strikers, because if you saw my stats earlier, he needs a little bit more damage, a little bit more push, because I also separate my and split my strikers in my teams, as you see over here. So I will have on my first team here, second team here, to know what exactly I want. So I have basically, that was the cable thing. So I will have 3 for damage and 2 for ignored dodge, because Null has a high dodge rate, as I told you in many of my videos. So all we have to do is use 3 for increased damage to super villains and 2 to ignore the dodge. So let's go. So we will go as we said, 5, 3 and 4. Again, as I told you in many of my videos, all you have to do whenever you face Null, and I hope you did it at the beginning. Okay, you did see that, right? This one I had to see it from when I just started doing Null with my Sarah, and you know Sarah's damage, right? So. There is a little trick. If you want to fulfill your tier 3 easier, all you have to do is use 5, 2, 3 and 4. But I suggest you to stick with the normal rotation. So yeah, so I will go and just kill him from now on. Three and 55 stage 2 with my stats, Ironman. He couldn't do it with his previous uniform. Okay, let's continue. So here there is no point for me to spend my tier 3 skill, because in the 22th, when this bar finished, he will make the ring down below into the corner over here. So be ready. It is always here, so you don't have to be afraid of where this circle will appear. So the next one that you have to be afraid of, it is at the 13 of the bar, when he is going into the middle and going up the bar. So if you have face here, this one, all you have to do is just go into the circles, you know, and avoid his little circles. If you can kill him here. Try to kill him, but if you can't, just go behind his back and he will roll from the behind. He's trying to target you, okay? So if you go behind his back, he will also face and focus the dragon behind his back. So you are free to move whatever you like. Again, the same thing. And that's it. At the 7th stage, all you have to do is let him go there and start charging with his symbiotes. When he goes to finish, the Thor appears and he's stunning him and we are able to hit him. So there is no point for me to go here because I'm getting damaged. I'm getting damaged. Did you see that? I got hit. So now he is not protecting himself, so he is easily able to die. And yeah, he did it. So as you see over here, there are a lot of easy strategies to finish every single game content into the game. I'm not making high-end game content because I don't have the right cards and the right tools to support it. Right now, I recently finished my third card and I am on the hunt of change the Loki one and the Black Panther one. In every video that I'm doing, I suggest you to have cards that for those two first stats to have all attacks. So let's say for an example, if you have those three cards, whatever substats I have, whatever I will get from here, I will have 30% from those over here. So whatever the reason, I will have all attack over here. So that is why I have 49% all attack. Whatever the reason, I will have at least all attack from there. So this is why I suggest you to get cards like, let me show you. So the cards that I suggest you are those over the three over here. And another three good cards that you may get is Luna. That is one of the best cards into the game, by my opinion. Another one card that is semi, you know, PV and timeline battle card. It is this one that is giving you also max HP and all attack. This because max HP is a very nice stat for you to have for characters like Hulk, because he is able to do whatever damage he does from his cards. What else? We have, yeah, we said already about this card. Let me go to the cards we have from the premium chest. So this card over here, it is also a very nice card. Those cards over here are just for crafting the, you know, your other cards, if you ask me. I'm not going to increase my cooldown and max HP because every card that I have increasing the cooldown and I have already maxed out. So I'm not going to spend one spot just to equip and get max HP and ignore defense, because I am able to get them also from from here also, ignore defense and all attack, and from here also ignore defense. So most of the cards have all defense. So I do not suggest you to equip this card or this card or this card, because this card over here has only energy attack. We need all attack for all of the characters, not only for the energy to be to have increased damage. This one is also a very nice card. This is not the best card, but one of the best cards also, because they have all attack. So I really suggest you guys, if you really have questions, I am here. I really helped a lot of guys to fix their cards, to fix their, you know, teams for null, or increase their damage on the Alliance Battle Extreme. All you have to do is just comment down below. I am really happy to make videos for this game, because, you know, if you ask me, I never saw a guy that is VIP 5 all of these years, because I'm not paying to, you know, to be good. I'm trying to buy only Stark stars and stuff, to buy some uniforms, because some uniforms like you know, Ghost Rider make the characters better. So you really need the uniform, and you cannot do it without some diamonds. So you really want to support the game. The least you can do if you don't have enough money, it is to buy the Stark Stars. That is just 5 euro close by. So the only thing and the only way and I'm thinking about paying into the game, it is because I really want to support it. They make, they do amazing work, and they keep doing it with the latest events they did. So guys, if you really want to support them, I'm really also happy, because this game is, I'm playing this game close by 6 years from the beginning, and yeah, I really love it and I will keep playing. So if you really have a question about any content and any character and I am able to help you with, I will gladly help you. So be sure to participate first on the giveaway. Don't lose your diamonds, it is yours, I cannot use them, so that is why I'm giving them free to you. They're not, you don't have to do anything, just follow, because I'm doing the competition on the Gleam because I want them to be right for everyone. So that is why I really want to choose at random, and no one is, you know, is about to say, oh, that was an edit and you made the winners by your choice and stuff like that. Okay, so that was the video. I hope you enjoyed. Until the next video, guys, see you again. Bye.